Now let us begin the presentation. It is about square numbers and certain interesting patterns. Square numbers and certain interesting patterns. Now the first one, 1, 3, 6, 10. All these are called triangular numbers. What are all these called? Triangular numbers. We try to add 1 and 3, and together you are getting 4, that is nothing but 2 square. Then I am going to add 6 and 3, then 6 plus 3 is 9, it is 3 square. Now we'll add 10 and 6 put together 10 and 6, 2 triangular numbers, and this is nothing but 4 square. So by adding first two triangular numbers, you are getting 2 square. Second one and third one, when you add, you get 9, that is 3 square. Third one and fourth one, when you add, you are getting 4 square. This is a pattern here. Now let us see one more interesting pattern with numbers between two consecutive square numbers. Okay, let us check these squares first. 1 to 40 numbers I put on the screen, and here we have 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36. I just shaded them. What are all those? They are square numbers. They
squares. Are, square numbers.
Very good. Square numbers.
Square numbers.
Now,
square
between square, 1 square and 2 square, 2 square is 4, how many numbers are there? 1, 2. 2 and 3 are not squares. They are non-square numbers. Between 4 and 9, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 numbers are there. They are non-square numbers. Like this, let us calculate. Will there be any pattern or not? Let us check. Let us check if any pattern is there between them. 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4. And between them, 2 and 3, 2 numbers are there. Okay. 2 square, 4. 3 square, 9. Between 4 and 9, we have 5, 6, 7 and 8, 4 numbers. Now 3 square, 9, 4 square, 16. Between 9 and 16, we have 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And this between these two, like this. Between 4 square and 5 square, we have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 numbers are there. So let us calculate each one of them. Let us, only 2 are there. I want to put these numbers as 2 multiplied by this 1. Now the second one here.
So the pattern is 2 and 3.
2 into 2 here. Now can you tell me what will come next? 2 into 3.
2 into 3.
Oh, sorry, here I put 6 here. I'll change it. I will change. 1 second, I'll change that. 2 into 3. Okay. Now the pattern comes like this. 2 into 3, 2 into 4. Now, we can easily say between 6 square and 7 square, there are 2 into 6. 7 square and 8 square, 2 into 7 numbers. That means the pattern is so simple. You take the smaller number. Suppose you are given between 3 square and 4 square, means 3 and 4. Small is 3, so 2 into 3 you say. So, the pattern comes like this. In general, there are 2n non-perfect square numbers between the square numbers of n and n plus 1. N and n plus 1 means 3 and 4. 3 is n. N plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4. Like that. So there is a pattern here. Suppose I ask you a question now. Between 9 square and 10 square, how many non-square numbers are there? Between 9 square and 10 square. 2 into 9.
So 18.
18. Very good answer. Very good. Between 10 square and 11 square? 10 square and 11 square?
20.
20 numbers. 2 into 10. Like this we can calculate. Very good. This is a pattern. Interesting pattern. Now let us see one more pattern. Now that is sum of odd numbers. Yesterday I taught you this one. Once again we will revise this. See here. Yesterday's also I am revising. I am putting in an orderly manner now. Now, all the odd numbers are colored now. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, all these are odd numbers. Let us try to add odd numbers in an orderly manner. Let us see. 1, that is nothing but 1 square, so I am not adding anything. I am now adding 3, the next odd number, to that one. So, first 2 odd numbers, sum of first 2 odd numbers is 4, it is nothing but 2 square. Now, sum of first 3 odd numbers I am taking, 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 5, 9, it is nothing but 3 square. That means, sum of first 3 odd numbers is 3 square. Now, sum of first 4 odd numbers is 4 square. Now, can you tell me what is the sum of first 5 odd numbers? 5 square.
25.
Now, first 6 odd numbers, first 6. Okay, here also I made a mistake.
36. 36.
You are right. 36. So?
36.
Right, right. 36. Yeah, first 6. First 7 odd numbers, 7 square. So in general...
49, sir.
49. In general, if somebody asks you what is the sum of first n odd numbers, then it is n square. So in general, sum of first n odd numbers is n square. I will ask you what is the sum of first 25 odd numbers. Then you need not go on counting 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, not required. 25 odd numbers are asked, so it is 25 into 25, it is 625, so simple. Like
625.
625, like this you can easily tell. Now the next one, next pattern for you is sum of product of two consecutive even or odd numbers, odd natural numbers. Let us take these. 11 into 13. 11, 13s are 143, you all know that. Okay, then. Is it not equal to 144 minus 1? Sure. That is for sure. 144 means 12 square minus 1. Remember, this 12 is between this and this. Between two consecutive odd numbers. So, product of two consecutive odd numbers is nothing but number between them. You take square it and minus 1. This is another pattern, new pattern for us. So again, 13 into 15, what is the number between them? 14. So 14 square minus 1, that is 196 minus 1, 195. So for bigger numbers, you can do quickly without multiplication. Now 29 into 31 also, 30 square, the number between 29 and 31 is 30. So 30 square minus 1, it is 900 minus 1, 899. Now I showed only odd numbers. Should I show you even numbers also? I will show. See here, even numbers. Now 16 and 18, if you multiply and check, you will get 288. It is nothing but 289 minus 1, that is 17 square minus 1. 17 is exactly between 16 and 18. Next, I will take 28 and 30. 28 and 30 is 29 square minus 1, that is 841 minus 1, 840. Now I have taken 44 and 46. It is 44 and 46 is between the number between them is 45. 45 square I will take minus 1, that is nothing but 2024. That is the product here. So in general, we have another rule there. Okay, now let us check some more interesting patterns with the square numbers. Okay, are you ready to learn more patterns now? Are you ready?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Now you can see a big triangle this side and that side you can see. What is there in this triangle? Here all these dots represent the multiplication. Dots represent multiplication. 1 yes, into 1 is 1 square, 1. 11 into 11, 1, 2, 1. You see, 2 has come and other two sides 1 only is there. 1, 1, 1 into 1, 1, 1 equal to 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. Wow. Pattern is forming now. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 into 1, 1, 1, 1. is 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, if 5 number 5
sir?
Ones, 11,000.
Sir, this pattern is easy, sir, but
easy. But you have to
sir, till 8 it is going, then again it is coming. Again from 7 to 1
yes,
it is coming,
yes,
sir.
Yes. If,
sir, left side there are from 4th digit 1, comma 3 is coming.
Yes, yes, yes. You understand. You understand. That's a nice thing. Now let us quickly go through this pattern. So the number of ones in a number here. For example, here 5 ones are making this number 11,111. Then you have to go from 1 to 5 numbers first. 1 to 5 you have to go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 you write. Then after writing 5 numbers, so up to 5 you write and descend. 4, 3, 2, 1 like that. Again, 6 digits, 6 ones make this number. 1,11,111 multiplied by the same will give you again 6 numbers. You will write in order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then we stop, again we come down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 like this. Any big number you can multiply. It is an interesting pattern with the squares. Now one more interesting pattern here, you see, wonderful pattern. Remembering is very difficult, but if you remember, you will become a genius, right? You will become a mathematical wizard, right? So, you have to play with numbers. If you go on exploring patterns like this, you will be very, very good student. Okay? Did you understand this pattern here? 9981. That you forget. 99 into 99, 9801.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, like this pattern coming. Sir, yeah. Like this pattern comes in pencil boxes and in the back of pads.
Yeah, pencil box back, etc. To make you feel interested in mathematics, is it not? So, learn these patterns. Whenever a pattern appears, study it. How it is coming, try to remember it. Then you will be a very good student. You will do wonders with mathematics. You can learn mathematics easily. Now some more patterns I am showing. 7 square, it is there in your textbook. 7 square is 49, 67 square is 4489, 667 square 444889. See, a pattern is formed here, you should be appreciating it. Last digit is always 9, then number of digits here is equal to number of 4s, then number of 6s equal to number of 8s here in this. Like that you can make the pattern here. So some more with 4, 34, 334, 3334, etc, etc. So if you remember the pattern, you can easily play with your friends and trick them and do the things very fast. Okay. So you have to collect such patterns, remember them. All these patterns, children, you... I am going to send you this PDF also. So, please keep this PDF with you. Go on writing these and ask your parents to make a copy of that one, printed copy. Write and you also collect some.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Tell me.
Sir, in the first 4 came, sir. Afterwards, 34. Why 34 came, sir?
Yeah. Only 34, 334 are forming the pattern here, therefore we have chosen those numbers. No special interest in 34 and 334, okay? Only they are forming this pattern, therefore we have chosen them. Understand?
Okay, sir.
Right. Now, coming to a small trick I tell you today, all of you concentrate and listen. Now you can see only a blank white screen in your mobiles or on the computer screen. You let us learn this trick. I am going to multiply 65 and 65 easily. I think I told you in 7th class. Once again I am telling you. Now take 65, 6, here also 6 is there. Here 6, here also 6. Here 5, here 5. So I am taking the first digit, adding 1 to that one. Next is 7. With this 7, I am multiplying the first digit. 42 comes now. Now I am taking 5 and 5, 25. Now what I do, this 42 I will take, bring it down. That is my first part of the answer. Now 25 I'll choose, bring that down. That is the answer for me. What is the answer? 4225 is the answer. 65 multiplied by 65 equal to 4225. Did you understand this one? Shall I show you again?
Yes, sir.
I'll show you again. Don't worry. Now we are taking 65 multiplied by 65. First digit I am choosing 6, adding 1 to that. Now with this 7 I am multiplying 6 again. 6 multiplied by 7, 42. First part of the answer is over for me. Second part is this 5 multiplied by this 5 equal to 25. Now the first part is 42. The second part of the answer is 25. And together you put them together, it is 4225. That is the answer. It happens for any
number. So for three digit number also like this only, sir?
Not with all the numbers. Any number which is ending with 5 only it happens.
Sir?
Shall we
sir, this is like Vedic math, sir.
Vedic mathematics, right. Who said this one?
Yes, sir.
Who said this?
Sir, Ashwini, sir.
Yes, Ashwini, good. Good, Ashwini. It is with Vedic mathematics. And the principle is like this. Yakadhikena Purvena. What is the principle? Yakadhikena Purvena. One more than the previous
sir?
One. Tell me, somebody is
okay,
asking. Yes.
Sir, in exams we should use, use the
number. Oh, good question. Subham, who is asking Subham? Who is asking this?
No, sir.
Somebody, who is
that? No, sir, I'm saying that. Sir, I'm Saket, sir.
Saket.
Generally, this type of tricks are not accepted in exams.
In exams, we don't accept. We don't accept. But you can use them in any examination where the time is very less. You can do it faster. To do maths fast, these tricks we use. Of course, in certain examinations, we ask you to do it without actual calculation. Then you can do like this. Without actual calculation, actual calculation goes like this. 5 into 5, 25. We'll keep 2 aside, 5 here. 5, 6, that 30. 30 plus 2, 32. Like this, you go on doing, is it not? Number, one digit, we'll multiply by one digit first, next digit. Next, those two we add up. All this is the traditional method. Without traditional method means you can do like this. Now, I will show you whether it happens with another number or not. I'll copy this slide and show you. Here, we'll copy this. Now, here we copy this one. Instead of 65, I'll take 75. What happens? Let us see. 75 multiplied by 75. So here I have to write 7. 7 and this is 8. Then
7 plus 1, sir.
7 plus 1, 8. So 7 into 8 I have to do 7, 8, sir. 7, 8, sir, how much? 56. So 56 I will write here.
56.
56 I will write here instead of 42. Then here also I will put 56, right? So this I will place on this one again.
Sir.
Right. One second.
So
5,650. Now this 42 I will avoid here. This is 56. Now let us see whether it gives the same slideshow or not. 75 multiplied by 75. 7 plus 1, 8. 7 into 8, 56. 5 into 5, 25. We will take this 55, 56 here. And we take that 25 there. And 56, 25 is the answer. So simple.
Yes,
you can calculate.
Sir, it will come only for...
Only for numbers which are ending by 5.
The
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, in 7th class you told us.
Yes, I taught you.
Divisibility rule for 7 also.
Divisibility rule for 7 also I taught you. You learned those. Okay, now coming to how to take a square, etc. There are many questions in exercise 6.1. All those we see one by one. one after another in the coming class. So now we'll stop the presentation and discuss more. Right, children?